suppose I would draw on Foucault, that we are all caught in webs of power that we perhaps not even aware of, and that whether we like it or not, we are always in a hierarchy of power where we are both sort of being submitting to it and enforcing it ourselves. And I was sort of interested in this, the nebulous nature of power and complicity, in a sense that guilt is never one-dimensional, and that you know, I think in this day and age, the concept of evil is talked about in these sort of black and white terms. But there's a lot of, you know, very interesting theorists who've looked at the concept of evil and, you know, how the banality of evil, as Hannah Arendt would say, or the sense that, you know, ordinary people are capable of extraordinary evil things. So it's that sense of the kind of the bleeding of power and complicity, and that, yeah, we all are, in every single act that we do, we are somehow, you know, complicit in all sorts of things. And I guess that brings up the issue of, you know, whether we are more accountable for the sins of commission or omission. And I'm not sure anyone really answers that question properly. Part of the human condition that we go through life hurting people, and that's, you know, we can't get away from it. But you know, I think it particularly comes to a head in this age of globalization, where we are really connected in all these myriad ways that are often invisible to us. And so we've, in many ways, I think, lost sense and lost sight of the structures within which we live, and that's the, you know, that's truly the, it's a dangerous road to go down, I think, where we've lost touch, you know, not just from, we've become alienated, certainly from the means of production, but I think also from, as a result, we've become less and less accountable for the things we do, because they are more and more hidden from us. And I feel this a lot in America, because, you know, having sort of lived here now through this war in Iraq, and having seen really nothing change at a day-to-day level, living your life in a country that's at war, and that's a particularly American thing, right? There's never been conflict on this piece of land except for the Civil War. But it's that sense that these things can be done in our names and yet so invisible to us unless you seek them out. And so that we get lulled into a sense of complacency, and our true, the blood that's on our hands is, you know, we don't see it. But I do think it still has a corrupting effect, and that you can't help but have your moral compass start to go awry when these sorts of things are being done in your name, whether you know it or not.